I don't know, do you
Billy's
have a favorite in
actually my
this?
coach too, so I can definitely pull for him.
Okay. Oh, I forgot about that. Okay. Dude, we could have casted TLO versus... Oh, well, no. I guess we would have got kicked out of it either way. So I'm not even sad about that one. Wardy would have gave us Das Boot. No way about it. So
no, I don't think Wardy would have actually kicked us out. He actually whispered me and said that Puck versus Euthermal was about to start as well if we were still looking for a game.
Damn. All of
just
them.
Because he knew that we were trying to get that. But I said I let him know we were sending viewers his way for... the matchup.
Okay, cool.
But,
so yeah, if you guys want to catch the Neeb game, head on over to Wardy. Dude, show some love to the fellow community casters. But I'm not even sad, dude. Pilly Pilly game is just as good, in my opinion. Maybe not as good as Neeb or whatever, but fuck. Give you guys a little bit of a backstory. We run a Plat Diamond. Oh shit, have we even done introductions?
We
no.
haven't even
yeah,
done
Yeah, I'm all
no.
fucking worked up. I'm sorry, guys. Our blue Zerg player in the bottom right-hand corner of the map, it is Namshar.
With dead pixels.
Dead pixels. Pixels.
And in the upper left, our red Protoss player representing PsyStorm Gaming, he is Pilly Pilly.
So all I was trying to say was that we do a Plat Diamond tournament every week, and as part of it, we have a show match where we take the two highest level players we can find, and we have a show match for $10. But where I'm going at with the story is we brought out Pilly Pilly three times, I believe. And we've given him monster opponents each time. It's not like we're just throwing him sacrifices or anything.
Exactly.
And he's never lost a single game on the Nidus. So I'm not biased.
He doesn't even
series.
Drop a map.
Yeah, well, that's what I was... Yeah, it's so ridiculous. So he's never lost a series. He's never lost a game. I've seen him take out a dude with four stalkers. Four stalkers. And I've seen him win a game. But, you know, I'm a Zerg player, so Namshar would be nice, too. Oh, shit, he's going to dance for us. Did you see it?
Yeah, he's trying.
Dinner
he's
and
basically
a show,
doing
dude.
This to... stop the minerals from mining. He's got that much free APM.
Yes.
And he eventually
dude.
Just steals a mineral and runs.
Yeah. Well, I don't blame him, man. All right. So from our Zerg player, we have Hatchcast Pool. And on the Protoss side of things, nothing too crazy. We know he really, really likes to get out those early stalkers, and he finds insane amounts of damage with them. I'm not saying that that's where this game is going to head, but that's what we've seen from him a lot in the past. So.
Pilly definitely has some very strong timings. It looks like he wants to open with some Oracle pressure. He is opening Stargate first. He verifies the presence of a third base, so he knows he's not about to be all in.
Dude, a guy that doesn't even watch StarCraft gave us $200 tonight. I'm not quite sure how I feel about that, dude. Like, that's so awesome. Thank you guys so much. I know you're watching on the big screen. I miss Broktos talking in chat because he's one of the active ones, kind of keeps things rolling along. But if he's listening to us on like a 50-inch fucking big screen, that's cool enough too, you know? So, nah, the dude donated $200. You know it's bigger than a 50-inch. These motherfuckers are watching on like a big old projection screen on his neighbor's house or some
they're
shit.
They secretly rented out the Super
yeah, seriously,
football
nah.
stadium and they're watching it on the...
Oh, shit. All right, so let's get serious here. Namshar is up to three bases, so he has that going for him. Tech Path is still Speedlings, nothing too crazy in the grand scheme of things. He's kind of taken sort of's route and just trying to play as greedy as possible, or at least as greedy as he can get away with here in the beginning. On Pilly's side of things, actually, you take Pilly's side of things. You're the damn Protoss.
Just have an Oracle so far. It looks like it's going to be the Oracle Glaives push that we saw several of our other professionals run into today.
Okay.
Just a couple oracles, at least one so far. It hasn't started a second one.
Okay,
he's gonna go straight into a Void Raider to deny Overlords.
Lekken Gaming says, looks like the Nidus is growing up. We're trying, man. We're fucking trying.
Yeah,
we definitely are out here trying to bring as much content as we possibly can. A bit of a spoiler alert. I'm a student who's in finals right now, too. So after, like, the next week, we're about to hit fucking StarCraft content so hard. It is unbelievable. So go ahead and hit that follow if you like what you see. We're going to start rocking our own tournaments. They're not going to be anywhere near as big, obviously. But they should have a couple $100 prize pools. So hopefully we can get some good players out. And now that we've had exposure to some of the top pros, maybe they'll fuck with us a little bit more. You know what I mean? Like, we have interacted with a lot of the best players in the game today. So that's networking as far as I'm concerned. So we'll try to bring you guys as best of content as we can possibly provide here. Looking into the summer, with $200 donations and shit, we should be able to bring something. Jesus. I know we keep coming back to that, but that's fucking huge. But Void Rays...
Yeah, Void Ray was just to deny Overlords, just to kind of shut down Vision, try to deny scouting, just do whatever he can to be annoying and limit Overlord Vision.
I fucking called it, dude. 65-inch 4K TV like a boss. Yeah, man.
RIP.
Yeah, I'm glad you guys are putting that TV to good use
That's
instead
like
of some bullshit TV show. Yeah, seriously. All right, so on the serious side of things, Pili Pili's trying to get this third up and running. Namshar's trying to shut it down with Speedlings, but because of that overcharge, that's definitely not going to happen. Resonating Glaives is coming in for Pili Pili. What else we got going on? Layer's coming down for Namshar.
We do have Roach 1 with plus 1 missile attacks on the way.
Yeah.
Which will help very much deny the adept pressure.
Yeah.
This pylon in the third base location is going to go down, but he's not really going to find any more damage than that. But
I hate being in this position as the Zerg player. You know that third is coming down. You want nothing more in life than to just try to cancel it, but because of all the adepts and the overcharge, you can't poke in there. So he's kind of forced to whether drop back and try to macro up or keep trying to just throw lings at this. It looks like he's going to come in for a third time. Maybe even just getting a probe would be cool, though, you know? So.
Well, remember, one feature of this map is, as a Zerg, you really can't afford to go late game because they're just, you literally can't afford it. There's
yeah.
not any bets you
yeah,
can take.
True. By the time you try to take a fourth, you're screwed either way, and it's pretty much
exactly.
impossible. Yeah, I see where you're going.
So
there.
You more or less have to either not die to an all-in
yeah.
or all-in yourself. And right now,
Oh, Fumek! Sorry. I know that was random, but welcome, dude. I think you participated in one of the tournaments one day, or at least you chatted so much that I recognize your name. So welcome back, dude. Also, they said 7 English streams streamed today, and this is a top 2 stream. Damn, guys.
Are you serious?
Please stop doing this, or I'm going to have to deflate my head, and I don't have a pin there, guys. So I'm going to need you guys to just slow your roll. But thanks for all the love. Nah, we really do appreciate it. We're just passionate people out here. We're very well known. There are not very well known. There's people with like 3,000 viewers, but it's pretty cool
exactly.
that we could just cast to, you know, 91. I'm happy with that. I'm not trying to get E-famous. I'm just trying to let these guys let me into pro games. We snuck our way into WCS, sure.
Sort of, kind of. It's like
it's pretty funny.
I'm not even on the official Nidus casting team. Like, I mean, I'm a backup caster, more or less.
Oh, you know you're
official,
man.
I got lucky that Gigglebear had to work today, and it's like, yes, I'm off.
All right, so this single Void Ray is over here trying to poke this fourth. We were kind of making jokes earlier, but it really is extremely difficult to hold a fourth down. It helps when you have this GM level creep spread and it's already touching the fourth. I can't manage that in my game. So I'd imagine that makes things immensely easier. Oh, is he going to get the cancel? No. Okay.
No, he sacrificed the Void Ray. If he'd had a second Void Ray or anything else to push the queens away from the Void Ray, he'd have canceled it.
Yeah.
But look at this. We have an Immortal Sentry. A debt push. Oh, and he's got Hydralisks that Billy found but couldn't revelate.
Yeah, so this is the big difference here, and I think the takeaway from this game. I can never hold down a fourth base because I never have the creep spread connected there. He got those queens over there so fast
yes,
that
exactly.
I'm learning. I'm out here learning. Imagine that, guys. You know, breaking news. Creep spread is good unit.
Like, good unit.
Yeah, like I'm a fucking dumbass. Sorry, guys. But no, I think that's phenomenal. And that's probably the reason why I have such a hard time trying to hold either this base right here or this base. But either one is a pain in the ass. But I don't know. We're gearing up for some really nice mid game here, though. We have a War Prison coming in for Pili Pili, so he's going to try to start that multi pronged harassment. But look at the amount of sentries there are. These force fields are going to make this really, really hard to get some DPS up and rolling here from our Zerg player.
He's going to be able to snipe this fourth base so easily
and
just
block him
off.
Yeah, like look at how many force fields there are available.
I don't like how far he is on creep right now, though. He's only got one immortal to anchor this army. He does have plus one attack, so he is going to be able to take some good fights, but he's going to get fully surrounded here. It's going to be difficult for him to fight this. He's actually force fielded off one side of the army.
Oh, there.
He's actually going to try to move.
Damn, that was so badass. He actually force fielded off half the reinforcements and efficiently blinked onto the other half. Started cleaning them up. Unfortunately, he's now surrounded. I think he might be cleaned up here. Namshar played this like a monster, and because he
Namshar
got that sandwich.
Got so much army.
Yeah,
Philip
that sandwich.
Extended, thought he could take it, didn't realize how much army there was.
Bit off a
Namshar.
Bit more than he could chew and got surrounded.
Quite literally.
So.
Quite literally, and then jumped down the throat of the guy.
Yeah. Dragon Soul asks, I mean, tomorrow, is StarCraft the only English stream, or are the 6 community English language streams going to be live as well?
Yeah, the only streams that will be live tomorrow for this event are the official stream, the official main stream, the
and base trade probably,
stream,
right? Yeah.
As in base trade, and then we'll have the foreign language streams.
Okay.
But as far as I know, it will be only StarCraft.
Yeah, that's a pretty safe bet. I know we were only given permission to cast day one when we shut down the stream today. That will be the end of our DreamHack experience, but I'm okay with that. It was so badass, dude. I don't even care. Like,
I'm not sure my body can take this.
Wait, make sure we get into the second game. Pili Pili wouldn't do this like that, man. Busy QU asks, are you streaming Puck vs. U-Thermal? If they fucking let us, dude. I'm about to stream every game that we're...
Puck is actually in-game.
Oh,
yeah,
so they jumped in. Okay.
But Namshire has hooked us up the entire night. I've never had to worry about him starting a game without us.
Yeah.
It's just so good.
Yep. We are ready to go. So, second map will be Cactus Valley. We'll have to see if Pilly Pilly is able to hang on here, or if Namshire is
He definitely was doing a very good job holding off Pilly Pilly that game. I liked the push, the denial on the fourth base, but I didn't like that he pushed out that far without a way to reinforce. He only had one Immortal in his army, and versus Hydralisks, you really need a little bit more meat with your potatoes.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. You need a little more shield with your sword or whatever you want to use there. Plogadice, I'm sorry that I probably butchered your name.
Later.
But he says, I really enjoying the stream, Frindos. Thanks, man. We're enjoying having you guys hang out with us. It means a lot to us that even 90 people are willing to watch us. So we don't try to get famous or anything. It doesn't really bother me that we don't have thousands of people in here. The people that we've had have been amazing all day. They've been really interactive and bringing the hype with us. So it makes it really easy to cast games for 8 hours when you have, 8 hours of cool people interacting with us. So it sounds lame, but thank you guys. Seriously, like, it means a lot. Oh god, Time vs. Snoot would be so badass. But I
got this game for right now, yeah, man. We got to just kind of have to roll with it.
Yep. Tell time to pause. No, I'm just kidding. All right, so nothing too crazy. We got a hatch coming down for Namshar. Hatch gas pull for him, and from Pilly Pilly, I was gonna say no ways.
His two gate pressure. His two gate opener. He does this on 4-player maps.
Yep.
So basically, it's more or less the showtime opener. He's going to saturate his gas by rallying to it. He's going to start his Cybercore on the low ground. He'll pause probes to get two adepts out, and then he'll take a Nexus. Basically, it's pressure earlier than most Zerg are able to A, scout, and B, prepare for.
Yeah.
Now, Lampshire has the luck of sending his first Overlord scout in the correct direction to scout the second gateway, so he'll be able to get enough Lings out to defend the first additional.
Yeah.
First pair of adepts.
A lot of stuff coming down in chat I just want to address real quick. First of all, they're asking if there will be a mass community stream type thing for DreamHack in June. That I have no idea, but given that it's the same event, I would imagine they'll allow us to put in applications, and the Nidus will be putting in to cast fucking every event that we're allowed to submit an application for. So I can't answer that question, with certainty, but we will put in for it if they open it up to casters. The other thing I wanted to address was, didn't Pilly Pilly win game number one? No. Namshar made a tasty, tasty Protoss sandwich, and I don't know. I mean, that's basically the best way to describe it. He caught him, surrounded him, and just chewed through his army, man. I don't know. It was pretty crazy. We save VODs if you want to go back and watch it. It was a pretty nice little engagement there in the end, but it was over fast, so...
Pilly's first two adepts moving across the map, seeing if they can get any damage done. It's been scouted, but there's only a few Lings in production right now. I don't think there's enough slow Lings to slow Pilly down. I mean, there's going to be Queens available, but as long as Pilly is able to find a good place to engage, I think he's going to be fine. He won't be surrounded. He's going to be continuing to focus down by the Queens, but he will be able to get out without losing them. He should be.
Oh, man.
As long as he doesn't get surrounded. Oh, he cancels it.
Yeah, everyone is kind of bringing him up to speed. It was a very, very good move from Namshire. He almost baited him into his fourth, kind of pretended like he was going to let him have it, but he was building up a surround and just kind of engulfed him. It was crazy. Like, by the time the engagement happened, it was already all but over. So it was very, very well executed from Namshire. And we'll have to see if he's able to do something similar, So
Pilly is getting shut down. It's almost like his mindset's a little bit addled.
Yeah, so well, look at how long they've been playing controls. Today, dude. These guys are putting in, 8 hours of SC2. I could barely do that shit by myself, much less in, a intense setting, a tournament or whatever. I can't even do that at home in my boxers.
4 hours at a time.
Yeah, seriously. He says, I would like to see that final battle done again. What if Pilly Pilly fought the north side of the army instead of the south side? Maybe he could have escaped. I don't remember. Yeah, I would agree there. He offensively tried
Pilly
to blink.
I think Pilly underestimated the amount of army there was.
Yeah.
When he moved south... pushed toward the army that was there. He didn't see how much was north because the sight blockers in the tall grass were making it very difficult for him to get a read.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure Pilly's going to all in.
Oh yeah, you gotta tie shit up, man. Like, it all comes down to this, you know? So, I wouldn't judge that at all. So he's got resonating glaives coming out. Oh shit. Nice.
Definitely, and he's gonna try to get an army up. He's getting a couple more gates. He's almost through with his robotics facility, so he's gonna be able to get a warp prism out.
Yeah.
But we already have a roach one completed. Lair is on the way, about a third of the way done.
Yep.
And we have four more adepts moving across the map. Not with updates, though, not with the glaives upgrade, so they're gonna
almost,
be as dangerous
though.
As they could be. Yeah. Yeah, glaives is close.
I don't think it'll be here by the time they poke in, though. It looks like he's trying to find a little bit of damage. He's actually going to take the shade out and poke in here and probably take it. Just trying to scout more than anything else.
Yeah, we that's do have the safest response.
Yeah, yeah. Just try to figure out what the hell's going on. Try to gauge the mid-game here. Found out that there was roaches, so that's a pretty significant pickup as is. He's going to try to poke out here and drop his third, too. So,
it may be faking a third, but he is actually going to plant one down.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I wouldn't rule Pilly Pilly out. It sounds crazy. Like, it's Pilly Pilly. He's never out of the game, but...
Oh, no, I was thinking he might try to take a fake third and all in, actually.
Oh, no, sorry. I was responding to the chat. He said, I wonder, nevertheless, Pilly Pilly still has a shot here. Yeah, he definitely has
Pilly
a shot.
Pilly played out of his mind in Katowice.
I didn't want to read it because I didn't know how to pronounce that. So, thank you for taking that one up, man. Katowice or whatever? Like, I always butcher it.
It's,
yeah.
It's more or less Katowice.
Okay. All right, so Pilly Pilly's just trying to measure up his opponent and figure out if he's going to be able to push on into this. Because of the amount of roaches, I'd imagine that's going
to
be no.
Depths, and he's actually going to push into the third base. He'll be able to at least pick off the queen. But he looks like he wants to try to focus on some drones. Drones very smartly pulled away. Pilly unable to find any drone damages yet.
Yep.
Scratch that. He's a... No, that's Namshar's kill, so actually I was not wrong.
Still nothing but roaches coming down for Namshar, too. Pilly Pilly knows this, though, and he's going to go, it looks like, the disruptor route, which I love. Roaches and disruptors play very well together.
Pilly on it.
You're the Protoss player. What's up?
Pilly had just hit his pretty sick supply block. He was counting on his Nexus for the supply, but it didn't finish as fast as he needed it to, so he was supply block for a good 10 seconds there.
Oh, damn.
That actually hurts a lot.
Yeah, we'll have
this
to
level of play, any supply block could be devastating.
Yep. So he does have a drop coming in, too. Looks like it just has a couple of adepts.
Blink Disruptor! I hope.
Yeah, that would be a ridiculous combo, too, especially up against an extremely roach-heavy opponent.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, you
basically
could get some really
mass
meaty...
roach. Disruptors absolutely meme your opponent into the ground.
Yep. So, definitely the correct response here.
Go.
It's all going to come down to the numbers of things. Namshar has been up on workers for just a little while, but it's only been like 4 or 5, so I don't think that's even that big of a deal, you know. So we'll have to see. Pilly Pilly does have his third up and running too. It's fully saturated, so that helps out a little bit with things too. But all of his aggression is just getting completely shut down here from Namshar. So.
He's able to maintain pressure though, and being able to keep his... Oh, he lost the warp prism.
Damn, I missed it. What was it, just queens took it out,
good.
Or the bios in combination with the queens?
It looks like he lost it to the queen.
Okay. Alright, so Pilly is transitioning into that mid-late game comp that is going to be Disruptor Blinkstalker. You called it, man. That's a pretty ridiculous comp here. It should do very well against the Roach Ravager, like extremely bulky units going down from Namshar, so... It's all going
to
come down to
about
this Disruptor
3 or 4
shot.
Before you can ever engage into this, and there's only one right now.
Yeah. Yep, Lekon Gaming says, 4-base toss is super scary. Personally, I try to never let the toss get even up to 3-base. You're doing it all wrong, man. If you played Zerg, all your games should end on 2-base. No, I'm just fucking around. I'm going to stop being the diamond, no regret. So Namshar is coming in and trying to poke into this third from Pilly Pilly. The overcharge comes down, and because of these force fields, he's not able to poke into it all the way that I'd imagine he'd like to. Yeah, look at these force fields. Just splitting up all this DPS and trying to take a couple of trades here and there.
Oh, good hit.
Yeah. Yeah, it'll be interesting to see if he's able to pull on here. It's 170 supply to 133, so Namshar definitely has the advantage there. The thing I like for Pilly Pilly, though, is those disruptors, man. All he's got to do is just kind of buy his time, keep those force fields up, and wait for those shots to recharge, and he should be able to start poking through here. So,
did Pilly lose a disruptor to a Ravager Bile? I didn't notice, but he's only got 2 disruptors, and he had 2 when that fight started.
Uh-oh. We'll have to see, man. He's sending an adept across the map.
Oh, he's finally getting some work done.
Yeah. Excuse me. All right, so Namshar's aggression was shut down effectively for the most part, but it looks like she's trying to gear up for a bit of a run by here up into the third. I really like this play, too. He should be able to find a little bit of damage there, given the fact that Pili Pili is moving across the map. He saw that rally, though, so yeah, I was going to say he's got to know that it's coming.
Entire army to Pili Pili completely out of position. The overcharge is going to go down, but all these Ravagers attack have such high DPS, and the army attacking the front wall is breaking into the natural base as well. Namshar is in. He's inside the main base, he's inside the natural base, and meanwhile, Pili trying to defend his third base, unable to hold against everything coming into his bases.
Yeah, this is just too much and too spread out, man. He's getting hit from all three bases at the same time here, and while he is taking a good fight here, it looks like in the main fight, he still took a lot of economic losses so far. Oh, wow, he actually took an insane engagement there. Holy shit, Pili is a beast. Did you see those shots go off?
Yeah, I did. Absolutely shrecked the army, yeah. But he's lost so many workers. The army in the main base still has not been cleaned up.
Yeah,
still focus there. Just
11 probes
down.
Went down during that, so that was crazy, dude. Sorry that I'm not able to count. You know, we don't have picture-in-picture like the Gauntlet, so we can't watch three things at once. Yeah, maybe someday when we grow up, but thank you guys for bearing with us anyway. That was pretty hype there. At least we got to see those disruptor shots, so, you know, not all is lost. Tudeming, we'll catch him if we can, guys. So let's finish up this one, though, man. It's not over yet. Pili was able to hold on into that aggression. So now tied
and
up
now
in supply.
Counter-checking.
Yeah, exactly. And because he has these disruptors, he's feeling froggy and might be able to poke in here and just get a lot of damage done. It's still that really bulky roach comp from Namshar. So these disruptors are just extremely, extremely potent here. So
what he's going to have to worry about is overextending again. He's blinking forward very aggressively, trying to take down these bases, take down the spike crawler, rather.
Man, I'm calling
completed,
it.
And he spots the Muta switch. This is actually the best place for him to be if he's fighting against Mutas. He needs to be on the other side of the map pressuring. He needs to not let the Muta get to the other side of the base, other side of the map, rather. Pressure on.
It's all going to come down to these disruptor shots, man. If he can find some really meaty hits here, he's going to swing the fight into his control. It's currently 162 to 140, so some really good disruptors here should do the trick, but it's going to be a matter of baiting him out and getting him.
Definitely. So, he gets the first one. Dodges very well.
Did you see? That was so sick. Yeah, that War Prism Micro was intense, dude. Again, picking up that disruptor and saving it.
Pili has some of the best War Prism Micro I've ever seen lately.
That was pretty ridiculous.
His Mutalisk's in his natural base right now. 16 more workers have gone down.
Yeah, unfortunately, Namshar's just trading too well here. He's starting to pick off a lot of the supply with just a couple bile shots and some focus firing. And now it's 166 to 113. Unfortunately for Pili Pili, he's just starting to bleed out a little bit here. So because of those disruptors, though, I'm not going to roll him out or anything. I just think Namshar's playing like a monster right now.
Pili really needs to find some damage here. He's bleeding out at home. He's continuing to lose workers. 23 workers down. He's down to 15 workers. This is Pili's do-or-die moment. His disruptor shots are connecting with massive results.
Yeah, but look across the map, man. Unfortunately, he lost 23 probes during all this. Namshar got across the map right here with these mutas and just did absolute work. Pili Pili is now on a timer. He needs to end the game or he loses, unfortunately. So he got a lot of work done. 13 drones going down is nice, but he lost so much. To these mutas. Namshar played this like an absolute monster. Jesus.
Pili microwing this warp prism with the mortals with everything he has, but the drones coming off the line even would be enough to fight against this army. And that archon going down, it is.